Welcome to the virtual launch of our book, 1500 Years of St. Columba. We are excited to share our story with you, and we hope you enjoy our short film.
In April 2021, three local primary schools embarked on a journey of discovery with the Church's Trust to learn about Columba. These schools were Fighting Primary School, Longtower Primary School, and Nazareth House Primary School.
This year marks the 1500th anniversary of St. Columba's birth, and we have decided to celebrate this by creating a book. The book that we have made tells the story of Columba and also showcases art, news articles, and poems written and created by us.
Columba was born in Garden Donegal in 521 AD. His mother was a princess of Leinster and his father was of the clan of Garden, a reigning family of Ireland. Columba was actually baptized crimson, translated as fox, possibly due to the colour of his hair. He was later given the name Columkill, dove of the church, due to his devotion to prayer.
When Columba was a boy, he went away to learn in several important monasteries and was taught by some historical notable saints. To finish his studies, Columba journeyed to Glasnevin. His education abruptly ended due to an outbreak of the Yellow Plague, which forced him to return home.
In 545 AD, Columba was offered the Island of the Oaks to build his first monastery. One day, the oaks caught on fire and Columba prayed to God to save them.
One time, Columba secretly copied a very important book of Psalms that belonged to his teacher, Fenian. Fenian was very angry as Columba did not ask to copy the book. Columba and Fenian argued about who owned the copy and even got the High King of Ireland involved.
The High King ruled in favour of Fenian, to every cow her calf, and every book its copy. Columba was not very happy, so he went back to get an army to fight the king. This fight is known as the Battle of Kildrevna and took place in 560 AD.
Columba got into a lot of trouble for fighting the king. The usual punishment for killing opponents' men in a battle is that for each person killed, a payment of 10 cows was owed. The decision was that Columba was to be sent away from Ireland.
On leaving Ireland, Columba promised to save as many souls for God as had died on the battlefield. Columba took 12 disciples and left Ireland on a curragh in 563 AD.
According to legend, Columba first landed on the Isle of Kintyre. However, he could still see Ireland from there, so he travelled further north and settled on the island of Iona. Columba and his 12 fellow monks established a monastery on the island. They spent their days farming, writing books, and spreading Christianity.
It is believed that the famous Book of Kells, now located in Dublin's Trinity College, was started by monks on Iona and then finished in Kells at a later date.
Almost 100 miracles have been attributed to Columba. The miracles include turning water into wine, raising the dead, calming storms, and walking on water.
One of our favorite myths is of Columba's encounter with the Loch Ness Monster. Columba and a group of his men had traveled to the area of Loch Ness to convert the people to Christianity. When they reached a village on the edge of the loch, people told them of a villager who had just been killed by a water monster.
Columba asked one of his men to swim into the loch. The man was nervous, but he trusted Columba and swam towards the centre of the loch. The bystanders on the shore were terrified when they heard a roar as the sea monster appeared on the surface beside the swimming man.
Columba was not afraid. He called out the sea monster and, making the sign of the cross, ordered the sea monster to return to the depths of the loch and never to harm a person again. The Loch Ness Monster bowed its head and disappeared under the water as quick as it had appeared, and it was never seen again.
Or was it?
Columba spent a lot of his time bringing peace to the people who lived in Scotland and Ireland. It is said that when he was near death, Columba saw visions of angels welcoming him to heaven.
Legend tells us that as the holy man approached death, his white horse, who had carried him faithfully for many years, laid his head on Columba's lap and shed tears for his kind master. Columba took his last breath lying at the altar in his monastery on Iona on the 9th of June, 597 AD.
Columba left a great legacy of peace and forgiveness, which we still know about today, 1500 years after his birth.
If Columba could see Derry now, he'd be proud of the walls in the Free Derry Corner. If Columba could see Derry now, he'd be happy to see the things in his honour, from St. Columba's Cathedral, Church and Park to our school. If Columba could see Derry now, he'd be joyful to see the ancestors of people he once knew living long, fulfilling lives. If Columba could see Derry now, he'd be amazed by how well children are handling the pandemic and by how much progress has been made. If Columba could see Derry now, he'd be delighted to see healthy baby animals and lots of greenery. If Columba could see Derry now, he'd be cheerful to see children playing with toys and making the most of their childhood.
The place is named in Columba's honour. In St. Columba's Park, leaves fall and kids can play. Bright young minds can study at his college. Churches, wells and roads are just a few things named in his honour. 1500 years ago, Columba lived, spreading his word about God. People still follow his lead, loving and worshipping God. Even though he is dead, many years his legacy still lives on, and forever he is remembered.
Columba lived some years ago, but what would he think now, with most of the oak trees gone and all his monasteries still standing strong, all these places, buildings and streets named after him, and even a couple of hymns? Even though he is long gone, his legacy still lives on. We remember him in our songs and prayers, filling our hearts with love and joy. He spent his life looking after the lonely. He made the arguing argue no more, and made the people more loving and caring. The world would never be the same if no one knew his name. The job of the church fly high in the sky up until the hour we die. We should follow Columba like sheep with their shepherd.
If Columba could see Derry now, he would be in awe of what happened to the old Derry, the Derry he founded a long time ago. If Columba could see Derry now, he would see all the traffic in Bishop Street as children go to school in the morning. He would see cars. He would see the cars driving by and see the hustle and bustle of people on the newly built Peace Bridge. If Columba could see Derry now, he would see children laughing and playing in the park named after him. He would see the people out on a nice sunny day in the famous Derry walls. If Columba could see Derry now, he would be very proud of the place he used to run around.
Columba the peacemaker. Columba the saviour of our trees and forests. Bringing the loved ones back from the dead, he spread the word of God to us. Oh, what a shame to upset him with no peace. He made the Loch Ness Monster disappear for us. Let's all pray and ask him for forgiveness. We shall remember him.
Derry's peacemaker. Caring for people big and small. Outstanding efforts to spread Christianity. Living life as Jesus would. Undoubtedly sorry, many died and more. Many lives changed through Columba's words. Best to say, he'll stand strong as this monastery stands tall.
My favourite part was when he vanished the Loch Ness Monster.
My favourite part was when he saved the boy.
My favourite part of Columba's story was when the monks went into the water and the Loch Ness Monster appeared.
My favorite part was when Columba could accept the land they called a monastery.
My favorite part would probably be when Columba burned the igloo.
My favorite part of learning about St. Columba was when he went to a village, and there was a patch of oak trees. The villagers who lived in the village, they loved the oak trees, and they were their pride and joy. So whenever the trees caught on fire, I really liked it whenever Columba prayed to God to put out the fire, because he risked his life to save the oak trees for the villagers.
I really liked the bit with the castle, because Finian went to the king, and then Columba went back to his city, and he got a war, and Finian got a war, so they fought each other, and then Finian won the war. Then Columba had killed a lot of people, and then he said afterwards, "I'm not going to kill another soul, and I'm going to start helping people that's dying and all." So.
My favorite part about learning the project is we learned lots of history about St. Columba and Derry that we wouldn't have known. Like, we wouldn't have known that St. Columba fought the Loch Ness Monster and he sent one of the villagers or one of his apostles out into the middle of the lake. And the fact that the apostle trusted him, it was incredible.
I really liked the bit, like, we learned a lot about Columba, and then we could just tell our grandchildren and our children what we learned about Columba, and we can show them the book and all, and then we can just say, "Oh, did you know that that Columba told the Loch Ness Monster they not touch any souls?" And then he told his friend they jump in the water, his friend had his trust and all.
I enjoyed doing the artwork for the project.
I enjoyed rewriting like a script for the book.
I enjoyed the quizzes and activities.
Bunny saved the woods from the fire.
Thank you for watching our film and celebrating 1500 years of Columba with us.